Konnichiwa YouTubers, it's Red Stock straight from Point Magoo, California. Today we're going to do a video review of Transformers Animated Grimlock. It's a Voyager size figure, so let's go ahead and take a look at it. I like the T-Rex mode, it's kind of neat. A few glaring flaws and gap issues that really irritate me, but nothing to the extent. I did do a rant before, I may want to show you that later, but that's okay. I do like that the chomping gimmick over here is kind of neat. I like that the little switch over here on the head, which is not obtrusive, which I intrusive rather. And you got great light piping, which I would always enjoy seeing or showing. So there you go, nice little light piping. Yeah. Okay, and I'll show you that later with his head as well. Chomping gimmicks. I like the little T-Rex arms. They do rotate, and this is my glaring flaw, is that why couldn't they cover this up like they did the G1 version? You can see the dude's head straight on there. And I don't know why people don't put that glaring flaw, but I will. I'll always point that out. I like the big T-Rex legs. You can see they become the arms. Other than that, it looks good. You can see the 2 points of articulation, which is kind of neat. So somewhat poseable, but the legs are so floppy, at least in my version. I like this little detailing on this. And this is one of the better molds I've seen from the animated line. It looks good. I mean, this figure's not bad. I like the Autobot symbol right there. Autobot symbol on the chest, even though it's clear instead of red. Definite gap issues that you can see over here. The thing's tabs well enough, but it seems to get untabbed a lot too. So you got that going against it. I do like that little gimmick right there. The huge gap in his chest. Gap over here. But trust me, I'm gonna deduct some points because of that. You can tell the dude's head or leg, sorry. And it's not as smooth over here, the connecting over here. So, you know what? I'll give it a 6 out of 10. Because it's trying. It really is trying, but all these gap issues don't make it look like a smooth figure. But trust me, the other mode, the robot mode, is much nicer. Which, you see, it doesn't move. Tail moves somewhat, so that's kind of neat. I like the joint here, ball jointed on the hips, so you can move the guy and pose him and get him in pretty decent poses. Yeah, it's not bad. Alright, let's go ahead and transform this. First thing we're going to do is disconnect from over here, and that becomes the legs, as you can see right here. So yeah, okay. All right, no problem. One thing I do like is that it does have a tab right here that goes right in here, and the legs do tab in nicely. So it was engineered more for the robot mode. Yes, split the legs, or sorry, the tail, and rotate. You don't really need to rotate. You can tell the chest will move up, so we got that. Ball jointed arms, and see if we're gonna push this in. There we go. Yeah, because he does have huge ape arms nonetheless. Trying to get that as in as possible. Good. Rotate the arms 90 degrees, and you can see the low joint. Same thing with the other arm, rotate it inward. I like the grip, the claws over here. Not bad. Almost transformed, actually. Very G1 reminiscent. We're gonna split these right here, and there's a tab here and a tab here, tab here, tab here. That head goes on that tab. I think if I can get it in there. And there is a tab here that tabs right here. So this lower portion does tab right into the back. So they really have thought more. And as you can see, this was much more well engineered than that for the robot mode. And finally, the little T-Rex arms just move in. So the robot, definitely better engineering on the robot mode. As far as articulation, it's pretty good for animated series. And of course, let me see what it comes with. Yeah, gotta love that light piping. Now the head does move, so we got that going for it. A little dark head too. It's very dark maroon color. I like the turtle mock turtleneck look. And I like how everything tabs, so his backpack isn't very intrusive. Ball jointed shoulders. It has this weird single joint now that you remove the elbow. And has a digit articulation, which I really like. And you can hold the, what do you call that? You can hold the his flame sword in any arm, but the gimmick works only on this arm right here. There's a little peg specifically for that, and I'll show you that later. Waist articulation, which is really good, really good. I like that. All right, what else we got? Ball jointed on the hips, single joint on the knee, swivel on the knee. So it's kind of weird. There's a little swivel on the top, if you can tell right there. I don't know what's for, mainly for transformation. And nothing on the hips, which I wish it had a heel spur, but I guess that is good enough. And I mean, it's not a very top heavy figure. There we go. Okay, and for a size comparison, there he is with, what do you call that, Megatron, my boy. And of course, another. So yeah, it's a Voyager size figure, so it is what it is. Okay, now that you got that, it's slightly shorter for a Voyager size figure. So something about weird about the animated line, which your Voyager figures were kind of short, but their deluxe figures were tall for some reason. All right, so you got that. Oh, one last thing, the little sword gimmick right here, and it's already popped out. So we're just gonna pop that back in. Sweet. Okay, and all we do is just put that right here. And see if it works. Yeah, so these spikes pop out. That's it. Show you that again. Maybe you can see it in slow motion. Put it in the hand. Ready? All right, this time it didn't pop out. Probably because of, I don't know. It is what it is. But I do like the sword, and hopefully the gimmick will work here. And if it don't, no skin off my teeth. So I do like how he can definitely hold his sword. Kind of loose, but nonetheless. All right, YouTubers, that's all I got. And I catch y'all next time.